Well, welcome everyone to today's webinar. We're going to talk today about networking with Andrei Homolenko, who is going to share some screen with us right at the moment. Yeah. And yeah, today I'm your moderator, Anton Belyakov, and our coach, our CEO, and our founder of Consulting Masters, Andrei Homolenko.
Guys, by the way, please be active in the chat. Let's do it a very interactive webinar today. Let's get to know each other a little bit better. If you have any questions, feel free to post them directly into the chat or just raise your hands. Anton will follow the chat closely, and we can basically, in this way, give you the most of the value of our expertise. Feel free to write a little bit more about yourself. Where are you coming from? I would be also very much interested to know, what's your current status? Are you a student? Are you an MBA? Are you an experienced hire or maybe young professional? What are you looking for? Maybe you want to join one of the prestigious firms, you are dreaming about career with McKinsey, BCG, Bain, or whatever the company. Just tell us your story, and we'll be also happy to share all our experience with you.
Right. And I'll be your motivator, so I'll help you to deliver these questions to Andrei, because sometimes it's very hard to stop here. But I'll be here. So just a few words about Andrei. For past 3 years, he has been running Consulting Masters as our CEO and our main coach. And for 6 years, he's been working in Rollenberger in Munich office, Kiev office, and Dubai office. He had more than 30 projects. One of these projects was even like Winter Olympic Games, if you don't mind, I'm saying it, because I'm always impressed with that thing, in your career. And for all this period, he was part of a recruiting team. So Andrea was the one who was recruiting people from that side of Rollenberger. More than 115 candidates came through his eyes and hands. Yeah. So, this is Andrea. And yeah.
Thanks.
Want to add something? Andrei.
Thanks for sharing, Anton. Actually, guys, I want to tell you a few very important things. I was born in Ukraine, but I started my career in Germany. For me, it was very hard with my background to get into consulting in Germany, because simply the competition in Germany was really, really very high. I mean, Germany is probably the biggest market for consulting in Europe, and the third biggest consulting market worldwide after US and UK, generally speaking. So therefore, it was pretty tough to get there inside. And what helped me really a lot to get into consulting were my networking skills and some curiosity and good communicating skills to people. And that's the expertise which I want to share with you today, give you some very practical examples how I was able to secure the interviews with all leading consulting firms. I interviewed with McKinsey, I interviewed with BCG, I interviewed with Bain, I interviewed with Rollenberger, probably some other companies. I don't even remember, because it was 10 years ago, back in 2012, or for the internship, it was even back in 2009, 2010. So I want to share with you the tips which helped me, a person with a handicap, because I graduated from Kiev National Economic University. Have you ever heard about this university? Please write into the comments yes or no. I just very interested. Have you ever heard about my university, Kyiv National Economic University? Guys, can you please just no. Anton had, yes, because you are from Ukraine.
I'm from Kyiv, okay. Yeah.
Most of you guys have never heard about this university, and you will probably never will, because this is like a no-name university. Even though it's quite famous in Ukraine, it's considered to be one of the very good schools, like among top three economic universities in Ukraine, but on the global area, it's a no-name, and therefore it is a non-target school at all for consulting, because consulting companies usually come and recruit at bigger schools and universities like London Business School, University of Oxford, for example, in the UK. In Germany, they recruit from Ludwig Maximilian University in Munich, LMU, or a technical university in Munich, or they recruit from the Otto Beisheim, Wehau, Ballender Business School, or EBS Business School, or University of Cologne, or RWTH Aachen, etc. So there are some target universities for some countries where consulting companies do specialized and focused recruiting. So they basically, they come on campus and they recruit, they try to recruit best candidates from every year. And of course, if you study at one of those universities, then it's a huge advantage for you. But what should you do if you are not among, I don't know, top 5% of the students who graduated from these kind of universities, then you're probably in trouble, and it gets harder and harder for you to get into consulting. And can you actually imagine what kind of a handicap it was for me, a foreigner who spoke German probably at best at level B2, not C1 or not C2. So my German at these days was just intermediate, I would say, and with some luck, a little bit upper intermediate. So one thing, of course, this race for survival, just try to make your CV as good as you can, just to make sure that you get invited for an interview. And on the other hand, actually also competing against Germans in German language on cases and personal feedback. That was a lot of fun, I would say. Yeah, so therefore, I want to share with you all this expertise and learnings together with you to make sure that you are also able to learn from this unique experience, and therefore, please be active in the chat, ask for questions, let's discuss, engage in discussions. And by the way, if you want to know more about me or about our company, Consulting Masters, just follow us on your suitable platform. I recommend highly to everyone to subscribe to our YouTube channel, because it has a lot of very useful material, especially recordings from all our previous webinars where we covered different aspects of the application and interview preparation process. But also follow our useful tips and content on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, or LinkedIn, of course, just to keep in touch with us. Now, I think the links should be appearing in the chat. Anton, please put them if they're not. Seems like Anastasia is not here. Okay, so now let's basically talk about the recruiting steps and why the networking is so much important. So in order to get a job offer, I would say Getting a job offer with McKinsey is very simple. You just simply need to survive the 6 steps. And if you have survived them, then you get an offer. So step number 1 is very, very easy. You need to apply with your CV and cover letter, ideally not through the website. Never apply through LinkedIn because you will not even get an invitation or any response from the company. The best way you can do this is, of course, to apply through networking. But now you guys, you are asking yourself, like, how shall I network? How does it work to network with McKinsey guys? That's exactly what we are going to discuss today. Then phase 2, you need to pass a McKinsey and Values test. This is like a game simulation. We also have some materials of how you can prepare for it in order to pass and go to the pre-screening or HR calls. And then you are expected to have 2 rounds of interviews with 2 to 4 interviews in total. So if you successfully pass all 6 to 4 interviews with, 6 to 8 interviews with McKinsey, hoorah, you will be among top 1% of the applicants who make it to an offer. Just to illustrate it a little bit more, I will also provide some statistics later on. But now let's basically talk why networking is so much important. I saw that also some of the recruiters or talent managers from other consulting companies have also registered to this webinar, and they might be among this audience. So yeah, these recruiters nowadays have become a little bit more lazy, which means that by contrast, 10 years ago, many recruiters were screening CVs, incoming CVs and cover letters through certain parameters themselves. And they spent a lot of time simply for screening the suitable CVs. Nowadays, it doesn't happen at all. Nowadays, most of the leading consulting firms have special software, ABS systems, which through specific algorithms actually select the candidates. So for example, if you have 100 candidates, but you only can invite 10 or 15 to an interview, so you let the ABS system running for you, which selects your 15 best profiles according to the criteria that you've put in there. And there is, therefore, as a consequence, most of the CVs will never ever be seen by human beings. And therefore, as a consequence for you, if you apply through the website, no bullshit, there is 90% of chance that you will actually get an automated rejection straight away, with a ban that you cannot apply within another 12 to 18 months one more time. So there is so-called ban period. But there is a trick. How can you maximize your chances to overcome this one? And this is basically through networking and referrals. This is a sort of that through this mechanism, you will get a chance to skip the line, basically to get your CV checked by the HR directly, avoiding the ABS screening test. And it works in the following way. Imagine 2 different situations. One thing is you apply through the website. Let's say you visit McKinsey.com or McKinsey.com/careers, and you put your data over there, you upload your CV or your LinkedIn profile, and here you go, you applied for a position. That's a standard way. Yeah, and then the ABS screens you, and then maybe within the next 2 weeks, in 90% of the cases, you get the rejection. But what if you have a friend or you found someone who is already working with McKinsey, maybe a consultant, manager, or in best case, even a partner who can put a direct word for you? Do you think would your application benefit from it hugely? Please write a comment. Like, what kind of impact would it have towards your chances of being invited for an actual interview? Do you think it has an impact? It's not relevant, or what do you think? Yeah, Jigar Shah says that, yeah, it would definitely be beneficial. David, it will help to skip the first phase. Yes, it will basically maximize your chances, because if someone asks the recruiter to look at your CV and even put a good word for you, like, say, let's say, Anton is the recruiter, I'm a consultant or a project manager with McKinsey, and David from the audience contacted me, forwarded to me his resume. So I would write a nice email to Anton, to the recruiter, saying something like, hey, hi, Anton, long time no see. I hope you're doing well. You know, one of my friends is David, is also eager to join our company. Here is his CV. I think that he could be a good fit to our digital practice. What do you think? Yeah.
That's first look at your candidate, of course.
Yeah. And if I write something like this to Anton, yeah. What do you think Anton will do with the CV of David? At least he will look carefully.
Yeah, look back.
Through that. Yeah, and that's exactly the tricks. So it's not a rocket science. And as Uluk Bek Hodjaev says, it works everywhere. Yes, the best thing is through networking and your connections. Yeah. Marcus Lux writes, probably depends if it's a partner referral or a consultant who has been around 1 or 2 years. Yes, Marcus, you are right. I mean, the higher you go, the better it is. But I would say that a very, very good recommendation from the manager is even more important than simply a forwarded email with your data through the partner. So, I mean, what partners do very often, they don't write these kind of personalized emails to the recruiters, as I just described with on the example with Anton. They simply forward the email from David to Anton together with his profile and write something in a comment like, for your information, or stuff like this. And therefore, these kind of referrals from partners are not that strong. But of course, if the partner engages himself or herself for this applicant, the higher engagement of a consultant, and by consultant, I mean simply a person who works with that company. It could be senior consultant, it could be manager, principal, or partner. So they all are consultants at the end of the day. So don't get me wrong. Therefore, the higher the engagement of the of someone who refers or who recommends you, who exposes himself or herself in front of recruiting, the higher the chances for you as a candidate to actually to skip the line. So that's exactly how it works, because through these kind of networking and referrals, we were able to actually to help 595 clients of ourselves to get placed in consulting companies worldwide so far. Okay, so yeah, now let's move on. Here is just some illustrative statistics for you, what it really takes to go through the application process. So this is the data from 2020, or maybe to even 2019, so before COVID years. In 2019, roughly 200,000 candidates applied to McKinsey. And only one third of them, like 33%, were allowed to pass to the McKinsey Balance Test, out of which another one third, so basically in total, roughly 10% of the candidates were actually invited to the first round of interview. And then only 6,800 passed to the final interview round. And yeah, about 2,200, or roughly 1.1%, to be precise, actually got the job. So you can see between step one and three, 90% of the candidates are being taken out of the whole process. So they don't even get a chance to be interviewed with McKinsey. That's why networking, especially during the corona and pandemic times, has become essentially important, because those guys who were able to network, they got two very, very important advantages in front of the other candidates. First of all, someone put a word for them. So someone was able to put their profile on top of the file. And secondly, through networking and through conversations with already existing and working consultants and professionals from the company, you can gain a very important insights and expertise about the company itself. You can better understand its culture. You can basically help yourself to prepare yourself way, way better to the first part of the interview, which is like a personal fit, so that you can get the deep insights and expertise about McKinsey or BCG or whatever the company is. And it will help you to provide better answers during the interview to questions like, why McKinsey, or why consulting, or why this, or why that, or where do you see yourself in 5 years from now? The more knowledge and insight you have about the company, this becomes your natural advantage during the entire interview process. So therefore, there are these two very common benefits of the networking. And my only advice to you would be, if you apply, please apply with networking or through networking and through referrals. This is also something that we can help you with to give you all the expertise over here. So let's go deeper now into the prerequisites. So in order to apply, essentially, you need to have two good things, basically two prerequisites for getting selected. First of all, you need to make sure that your CV is in the top notch, actually in the pole position. It should be polished. It should be one of the best CVs that the recruiter has ever seen. And there are certain things which are important here. So recruiters are looking for big brand name employers or schools. So this could be, for example, I don't know, big experience in the big four audit companies or in the leading companies in their sectors, in economy in your countries, or simply multinational corporations, something which everyone is familiar with. So for example, when I started working in started my studies in Germany, my goal was first of all to get some internship experiences with the leading companies in that country. And for example, I did an internship with Mercedes-Benz or Daimler, simply to put this brand name on my CV, because everyone knows Mercedes-Benz. It's a worldwide brand. Or I don't know, in the US it could be Coca-Cola or McDonald's or whatsoever. Or KPMG, Big Four, Deloitte, whatsoever, or banks are also good brands to put on your CV. And on the other hand, your top schools. So for me, it was a handicap. I didn't have a top school to show. So that's why I also needed to compensate it with high academic grades. My GPA, I was among top 1% in terms of the grades when I graduated from the high school in my hometown, or also I was among top 10% of the foreign students everywhere where I started. Then I also used to have quite a lot of leadership experience and people skills, like so-called social engagement, especially in DACH region in Central Europe, but also in other places worldwide. They do pay quite a lot of attention to your extracurricular activities. Yeah, and then of course, if you are already a young professional or experienced hire, you need to showcase high achievement career experiences. So high or quick promotions, so to say. Etc. So all of this needs to be put on your CV. And I just want to give you some very brief recommendations regarding your CV. So generally speaking, so this is just an example of a candidate. So your CV should ideally fit on one page. One page is the most common design for a CV worldwide. In some countries like Germany, like Canada and Australia, they do also accept two pages CV, but the one pager is the most common standard actually worldwide. Yeah, and your CV needs to be done with a conventional font like Arial, Times New Roman, and font size of 11 or more, and feel free to pay with to play with margins within those. From the structured point of view, I would say if you already have a working experience, put it on top. If you are currently studying, then put education on top. But beside these two, also please put your leadership and extracurricular experience, as well as interests and other additional information. So these four paragraphs and categories should build a really good CV. Then make sure that all the bullet points are actually demonstrating the personal impact of you as a candidate. And those bullet points should demonstrate a balanced mix of the following skills. Number one, problem solving skills, leadership skills, entrepreneurial drive, and personal impact. And then also make sure that you actually use the verbs in the past indefinite tense to express yourself, and make also sure that you underline your bullet points not as a process, but as a result, and that you can enhance it with some facts, figures, numbers, percentages that could be interesting to the interviewer. So for example, increase product revenue by 15% by adding new software features, basis market insights, and stakeholder interactions, or reduced software bugs, backlogs of 10 years by 100%, etc. So these kind of things. What will also help you in the education part of your CV is to illustrate your high achievements, like GPA 3.9 out of 4.0, top 10% of the class, something like this, or winner of the Europe's business simulation game, or winner of the case competition, or honored with the scholarship, these kind of things. They will help to boost your profile immensely. Do you have any questions about this, guys, before we move to the networking part?
I'm sure, Andre, we will find some questions here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, Savita Saranivasan. And by the way, please, guys, if you're sending the questions, please don't send them to me directly, but send them to the chat, because I'm not always to all, so that everyone can see these messages and Anton can read them, because I'm not always able to jump between the screens and read all your comments. So, hello, are there any specific templates to be followed for each country, other than the number of pages? Well, there are certain templates for some countries, but we use standardized and very polished templates. There are some, so we have a selection of really, really good templates. This you can find if you decide. Basically, you can buy our course about CV and cover letter writing, where you will find the most suitable and the best templates for each specific region and a country. So, for example, if you are applying to Europe, it's a one template. If you apply to the Middle East, it's a little bit different one. If you apply to the US, it's a third one, because there are some specialties about it. For example, if you apply to the US, you are not expected to showcase your photo. By contrast, applications in the Central Europe are more welcomed with a very professional photo on your CV. Feel free to reach out to our team, or to go and directly book the course through the website. We will be providing you with all the templates and the guidance, basically, on how to create your CVs and cover letters according to the standards in consulting. Okay, if there are no more questions, then let's basically move on to the networking part.
Yeah, we can move on. Welcome, Savita.
Okay. All right. Perfect. So, networking. Why networking? Basically, there are some key principles as for the networking that will help you to do it in a more efficient way. So first of all, think long term about networking, because it will actually help you to better prepare for the job. And even after you have become a part of the team, it can help you to accelerate your career and your promotions. Always be humble but confident. So be flexible, but never underestimate yourself. And you need to network regularly. So how does the network actually work? I want to show you something. Let's stop presentation for now. And let's go to the LinkedIn. So if we go to the LinkedIn, I just want to showcase you a few examples how the good networking could work here. Anton, by the way, is my screen visible?
No, we don't see it. You have to demonstrate another screen.
Okay, yeah, then I'll demonstrate it. So now you can see we are here, we are on LinkedIn, right? Let's imagine we want to get the job with McKinsey. One of the best ways would be to search for McKinsey. Feel free to apply here the filters. I would say you put simply your desired company in the search field. So as you can see, I'm already biased. I have 147 connections based on my friends, former colleagues, other alumni and our clients who are currently working with McKinsey. And I would say these are just the direct connections. Indirect connections like second row connections could be even more. That's why our company, we also do help quite a lot with networking and referrals as well. So you search for McKinsey in people. Here you can put your connections. It could be, for example, in my case, it could be even first connections. In your case, it could be second connections. So, or first and second connections. Imagine that you know someone or one of your friends or maybe someone from the family is working with the company. So put here either first or second degree connection. Then in locations, you can basically put something that you're looking for. For example, I don't know, United States, Germany, United Kingdom, or maybe United Arab Emirates, if you are looking for the careers in the Middle East. Then you click on show results. And here you can already find 145 for, in my case, working over there, and you can start reaching out to them. So here, by the way, so current company, just put McKinsey here to make sure that, yeah, those people are still working there and not are just alumni. And here, you can also use other filters. What is interesting here is, for example, current company, McKinsey, and then the school that you've been visiting. So for example, you've studied at London Business School or at University of St. Gallen. You click those two here, and then you can show the results. So for example, I can see that Lara Hick has been visiting, has visited probably the same schools as I did. So I can reach out to her even better. So your first step in the whole networking process is to identify who are the potential people whom I can approach. So you need to search for your target group, for the people who have something in common with you. And this could be that people were that you were studying at the same university, or you are coming from the same country, or I don't know, you share some other traits. So for example, nowadays there are quite a lot of female leadership programs within the leading consulting firms. And if you are a female, you have a huge advantage because you can basically easily connect to other females who are already working in consulting, because female leadership has been boosted over the last few years, and now it's even boosted even more. Or I don't know, we even had a chance, had a candidate who was a member of LGBT community, and that person also very successfully, with our help, connected to some other LGBT activists in the community, in the consulting community, basically was able to receive the interviews with most of the leading consulting firms, simply due to the origin and LGBT part, because all of the companies, they claim diversity nowadays, and they rank it very, very high. So therefore, even these kind of minorities can do play a good role. Or otherwise, I don't know, you are very much interested in a certain functionality or in a certain industry. So feel free to find the experts who are working in, with McKinsey or other leading companies who are specialized in the areas that you are currently looking for. So for example, if I see that, okay, it's Lara Hick, then we go up to there. With Lara, I have an advantage that we used to both work together at Roland Berger. I even know her personally. So basically, it will be very easy for me to connect with her. And in the next step, it's very important that you write very tailored messages to those whom you have identified. Anton, do we have basically any questions from the chat? I saw that was quite a long one. Okay.
No, people are listening. Yeah.
Okay. Good. All right. Just let me know if there will be any questions. Okay. So the first step was to identify the right people. The second step is to approach them either on LinkedIn or by email. I would even recommend by email even more. And then the third step would be basically to get a coffee chat, to ask them for a coffee chat with you so that you can expose yourself. So, for example, let me now get back towards the presentation. Is my screen now visible, or do you still see the LinkedIn visible? Okay. Yeah.
No, still a LinkedIn, I thought.
LinkedIn?
You have to switch the screen. Still LinkedIn, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, thanks. So I want to share with you an example of a very good email, what you could write. So for example, let's imagine that you used to study with the same at the same business school or university as Lara. So you would write something like, "Dear Lara, greetings from London Business School campus," or I don't know, whatever your university email, whatever your university is. "I hope my email finds you well." So this is like a brief introduction of yourself where you can put, to see that if you are using the alumni network, mention the name of the school at the beginning. Yeah. Then in the next part, you tell briefly a bit more about yourself. So you can tell about what you are currently studying or remind the recipients of their younger days in the email. So that could be like, "I am an MBA from London Business School, where you are a distinguished alumni. I'm sure our college memories are still lingering in your thoughts." That's a very particular moment because here with this sentence, "I'm sure our college memories are still lingering in your thoughts," you're trying to build some emotions with the recipient of this email. So to make it a really personalized email, not just 100 emails that consultants receive every day, but yeah, you're trying to make it very personal. Yeah. And then, "I found you on our alumni directory and then through LinkedIn." Yeah, then in the next step, you basically explain the recipient why you found them. So do some research to express a positive opinion on recipient's past achievement. So for example, you can say, "I have been following your career for some quite time and was really impressed by your personal growth, accomplishments, and personality. The feedback and recommendations your clients gave to you over LinkedIn are amazing," with a smiley. So if you, the more you can find about them, that person, basically stalking their profile, reading their recommendations, their publications, studies, recent posts, whatever appeared on LinkedIn over the last year with them. All of this as part of good research you can use in order to customize these messages even better. And then tell the recipient about your career aspirations. And the best way to do so is to refer to their own career path, basically. So that could sound something like, "I am very passionate about taking my next career step in consulting after my graduation in a very similar way as you did a few years ago. And I would really be happy if you could share some of your valuable experience on how to break into consulting and company XYZ, in this case McKinsey, in particular." Yeah, and then the next paragraph is really very important. It's the key in your networking skills. It's about arranging a meeting. So many people are doing so many mistakes. They're not asking politely, they're not asking directly. They write something, "Oh, it would be nice if we could chat," or whatsoever. Yeah, but the main goal, your recommendation email, is that very, very last paragraph with these two sentences. So in this example, it is formulated as the following. "Would it be possible for us to have a quick coffee chat? ? And then, do you have time this week or next week? ? Yeah, and then best regards, your name, your MBA cohort whatsoever. So this very, very last paragraph is essential, is very key. So guys, bear in mind, this is how you need to write the email. This is one of the examples how to do so. We have in our video course even more examples and even more details on that in order to uncover this topic in all the details. So what do you think? How did you, do you like this email? Does it make sense to you? Is it logically structured? What do you think, guys? Please leave your comment in the chat. And while you are typing, I want to share with you also some other bonus mailing tips. Basically, approach people always with whom you have the commonalities, with whom you have, with whom you are alumni of the same university, or you have same background, or nationality, or members of the same societies. What I figured out over the years is that the response rate to emails is statistically higher than to LinkedIn messages. And you can actually search for emails of almost every person also online. So in most of the companies, it could be like name.surname@companyname.com. So in that particular example, it could have been lara.hick@mckinsey.com. But bear in mind that for McKinsey, the format is a little bit different. So it's not with the dot between name and surname, but it's with the below slash. So therefore, you can search for these emails. And if you send the email instead of sending the LinkedIn message, the response rate might get even higher. Then, when sending the emails, your goal should always be to organize a call, a coffee chat, not to ask questions. Yeah, later you can basically use them during the call for the questions. And you need to close the call with an indirect request of a referral. So don't leave that to the chance. There are also very, very specific ways how to do the networking coffee chats, which we can maybe tell you in one of the next webinars. Or for more details, I just give you a little bit the scratch of all this information. But of course, there is so much what we can share with you about networking. I also want to point your attention to the most common mistakes. But before that, I also want to read your comments. Yeah, so David wrote, fantastic structure. Thank you, David. Jigar wrote, it's an amazing and logical structure. Yeah, guys, just use these example of the email. Yeah, but pay attention that there are quite a lot of common mistakes which you could do in terms of networking, which will make it less resultful for you. So first of all, don't rely very much only just on LinkedIn as a pure source of networking. I mean, nowadays you can also do the physical networking. As I already mentioned to you, if you found someone on LinkedIn, it's better to send them both the personal message back as well as then as an email. Please don't send standardized message to your potential contacts. Always try to customize your messages to every individual as much as you can. Because you know, When I was consultant, I felt it's so disgusting. I mean, I received like thousands or sometimes even hundreds of messages over LinkedIn from some Indian guys or from some people whom I barely know, who were asking me, like they're writing to me standard messages, and I, as a consultant, I didn't even have time and desire to respond to those messages because they were all written in a standardized way. So that was a clear indicator for me that people don't do their research necessarily. And I always, or in most of the cases, I asked to those few people who were writing to me thoroughly, who were adjusting the messages to me, who were picking something individual or some ties to build their rapport with me. So therefore, make sure that you invest a lot in terms of research to make sure that, that your messages are very much adjusted. Yeah, then, last but not least, as I mentioned to you, don't ever apply through LinkedIn. Just don't even think about it, because you will never receive an answer. So no one will even get back to you. So, you know, like, the easier it is to apply, the more people are applying through this channel. But it's all like scrap, in all honesty. I know that networking is the hardest way to apply, but it probably brings you the best insights and the best results because it really maximizes your chances. Of course, it's a lot of effort. It's hell of work. But it definitely, definitely makes a lot of sense. And most of our clients who apply through this strategy using all our materials, technology, plus, of course, our network of consulting masters, they do get interviews with 3, 4, five consulting companies on average. And they are able to get at least 2 or 3 job offers in consulting, so that at the end of the day, they can still choose whether they go to McKinsey, Berger, BCG, or whatever the company you prefer. So yeah, guys, it's really, I couldn't even stress it that much. Okay, I also see some comments from Kevin Elementor, very insightful. Yeah, and from Anu. Hello, will there be a recording for this session to review later? Anu and everyone else who want to watch this recording, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. And by the way, put a like, leave a comment under this video. And if you're watching us over YouTube, share it also with your friends who might be interested in consulting. And also, please leave a comment about what do you think about networking and consulting, and how did you like this webinar? Okay. Of course, I was only able to give you over an hour, just, I would say, the first 10% of the entire information. But if you really want to get all the details, if you really want to understand how, for example, how to create your plan for applications, or how to create a very, very nice CV, in the right template, what to write over there, what not to write over there, How examples of those CVs of the candidates who already passed through the interviews and got the job offers look like, and what can you take over from them? All of it is available, and we have actually prepared several video courses. I think Anton and Anastasia will now share the links. Feel free to visit our website, Consulting Masters in Video Course. You need to go and you can purchase those courses online, and especially the networking course will be also very, very much useful for you, because here we just scratched on the surface. But in that course, we go really deeper into the detail. How to find the right people, how to indicate them, how to approach them, how to answer to their messages. And most important, what should be your attitudes, your mindsets through the networking? And especially, how do you need to lead the dialogues with consultants? How do you need to convince them to give you the chance that you are the one? How you can basically, within 30 minutes, convince someone who doesn't know you to give you a recommendation at one of the leading consulting companies? That's probably the key. All of this and even more you can experience in our networking course. And of course, if you are interested in all the interview preparation, like how to solve the cases, how to develop your personal stories, how to basically pass all of this, we offer full ranges of courses. Anton, can you please share the links? They still not yet appeared in the chat with everyone. So just visit our website of Consulting Masters and our video course. And as for now, I even have a special gift for you, as I promised to those kids who were brave this year. As a Santa and a Saint Nicholas, today I want to give you a special offer. So everyone who watches this video online or who visited this webinar, before this Christmas, feel free to visit our website and purchase the course, and you will, if you contact our team, you can even get the coupon for 30% off on every of our course till this Christmas. And also, guys, I will be very, very thankful to you if you could put a like under this video, if you're watching this on YouTube, or leave it as a comment, or share it with your friends. And also, don't forget to tag us in your social media as a gift for us. That will be really amazing. Yeah, and I also want to give you another gift. Feel free to apply and book a strategy call with our expert Anton. Here is his Calendly link. Anton, please also share the link in the chat. And what else, basically? That's probably it. I'm happy to answer your questions, and I'm staying at your service. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, activate notifications to get invited to the future events, and we are happy to serve you. By the way, before we jump into the Q&A session, I want to remind you that after the new year, we will have another webinar, which will be dedicated to MBB Insights, McKinsey BCG Bain, how to get a job at the prestigious consulting company in 2023. So it will be on Monday, 2 weeks after Christmas, 9th of January 2023, same time, 19 CET Central European time. And thanks for being with us. Thanks for your tags in social media, LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, or TikTok. Thanks for your likes and shares on YouTube. And I'm happy to answer all of your questions. So do you have any? Feel free to raise your hands, turn on your cameras and microphones, briefly introduce yourself, and also asking your questions. So, Anton, do we have any messages? I think there was a long one from
Kevin. No questions so far. We have some great news. You know, people they say thank you very much, Andrea, for this insight webinar. But guys, please feel free to raise a hand and ask some questions if you have any.
Kevin is writing, good day all, glad to be here. I'm Kevin, I'm from Nigeria, currently in London, certified management consultant from IMC Nigeria, and also cleaning management consultant certified by Cleaning Management Institute, New York, USA. I'm here because I want to improve, learn more, and delve into other aspects of consulting. And I'd like to be proper consultant specialist. Thank you, Kelvin. Okay, Kelvin, feel free to get in touch with us and book a call with Anton. All right, David, fantastic structure. Then Kevin, very insightful. Anu, okay. Hello, will there be a recording of this session to review later? Yes, there will be the recording. You can basically watch it online on YouTube. And please subscribe to our channel, leave a comment, put a like, to this video, as well as share it with your friends. I think it was a really great one. Yeah, we'll look back. Thank you. Can we receive recording? Yes, of the Zoom meeting. Same comments as well. Okay. David, thank you already. Savinta, thank you very much, Andre, for this insightful webinar. I have surely learned a lot, and I'm hoping to get opportunities at companies such as McKinsey. Yeah, sure. So in town, happy to serve you, and feel free to get in touch with Anton, book a call with him, or simply directly use the 30% gift discounts from us to book a call this week. Okay. David, hi, I'm curious. Can you specify the actual services you provide if an individual sign up? David, generally speaking, we provide the full range of services. We help you along the entire way towards helping you together. So we help you to develop the plan for your applications. We help you to develop, craft, and polish your CV and cover letter one once it's ready. We give you the entire guidance. We can help you, of course, with the networking, the topic that we were talking today, to help you to maximize your chances for consulting interviews. Then we can also assist you towards the interview preparation to make sure that you are passing every step of the interview process, starting from the tasks and HR calls up to the first and the final interview rounds with the partners, and then even with the offer negotiations. And what we also offer to some of our best consultants, we even can help you to pass successfully your probation period and help you to start building very solid reputation to get your promotions way faster than the others, and avoid negative situations, because with McKinsey, BCG, and Bain, and other leading consulting firms, they have upper out policy, which means that, yeah, unfortunately, 30% of the candidates who get into consulting are, yeah, being kicked out within the first year because they don't meet the requirements of the company. And it could be a huge stress if you are outplaced already within your very first year. So we help you to survive. We help you not only to survive, but also to put yourself in the leading position so that you are being considered as an outperformer. That's what we help with. To find out more details, David, just get in touch with Anton and book a call with our expert. Okay, Aditya. Thanks, Adrian. That was a great webinar. Aditya, thank you very much. Another question from David. Also, I'm an experienced professional over a decade experience in banking and now in a big brand in Europe. My lifelong goal has been McKinsey. I'm looking to working with you and hope my dreams come true. Sure. Yeah. Happy to help you, David. Jigar Shah. Thank you so much for your insights. I will surely make the necessary changes in my CV and also will use the referral mails as recommended by you. Yeah, Jigar, happy to help you. Feel free also to use the discounts that we are providing only this week, so until Christmas, until the 24th of December. You can get all our courses with 30% discount. Yeah, if you don't have any questions, then I would only say a big thanks from me, from us, from Consulting Masters team for being with us in 2022. This has been one of the most challenging years for me personally, but also one of the most exciting. And I'm so happy that we were able to bring roughly 100 people into consulting this year on different positions. Very soon we will be rocking and celebrating our mentee number 600 to break into consulting. And yeah, who knows, maybe you'd like to be one of them. Feel free to join Consulting Masters family. Get in touch with us. And thanks for your comments. Thanks for your contributions. Merry Christmas to you guys. I even just received today the greeting cards from Roland Berger partner, Norbert. I don't know if you can see that. And this is also part of networking. So being in touch, in contact with colleagues. So thank you very much, all of you. I wish you and your families stay blessed, be happy, be joyful, let your dreams come true. Remember, if you have career aspiration in consulting, I have some good news. There is a lot of massive actions waiting for you in the next year. And we are happy to help you to help your aspirations come true next year. Thank you very much for being with us. Big hugs and love, and yeah, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I'll see you. We are looking towards seeing you next year, Monday, January the 9th. Stay blessed and take care. Bye-bye.
Merry Christmas. Thank you, guys. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Kevin.
Bye, Idris. Bye-bye. Bye, Kevin. Bye, Jigar. Bye, Anu. Bye.
All right.
Yeah, I was asking, there's a WhatsApp platform.
A WhatsApp platform. You want to join some WhatsApp platform, Kevin?
I don't mind.
Yeah, we have. We have.
You can first. You can first join me in.
You have our member, and you will get. All right.
Sorry?
Thanks. Thanks a lot, guys. It was such.
You can join me on LinkedIn first.
Okay, I will. I will.
Okay. I shall. Here's the link.
Okay. Bye. I'll send it.
All right.
Okay. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye. Bye.